I like color in my life, but when I can't get that, I'm content with adding color to my VIs. A lot of beginning programmers ask me how to do just that. Well, here's a simple VI that I would like to make colorful. First, I need my tools palette. I can either hold down Shift and right click, or I can go to View and Tools Palette. At the bottom of my tools palette, I see two overlapping squares, one for the foreground color and one for the background color. So I'll click on the foreground color and choose this lovely magenta. Similarly, I'll click on the background color and choose this delicious lime. And now, every foreground color object that I click on with the Set Color tool, which is this paintbrush, will turn to the foreground color, like this boolean, or this increment-decrement button on the numeric control. Any background object I click on will turn to the lime. Foreground, magenta, background, lime. But that looks terrible, so I'll hit Control-Z and undo that. With all this coloring power comes great responsibility. Some unleash their inner Jackson Pollock on their front panel. This looks like a clown face. Ideally, color should be used as an accent to draw attention to important items. But when everything is colored, this purpose is lost, and the user becomes disoriented and could pass out. Don't do that. This is more pleasing. If I go to the block diagram, I can see other great places to use color. For instance, many structures do well with a light gray or pastel interior to differentiate code inside. My tool currently is the Set Color. I'll hit Tab to bring it back to my Position Size Select tool. Going to my Structure subpalette, I'll put down a case structure. If I want code inside of here to be a different color, I'll first go to my background and choose a muted color, like this grayish color, and click. Again, the case structure itself would be a foreground object and would turn magenta. Undo. In the situation where I have many nested case structures or event structures, now I can easily see which code belongs in which structure. Another nicety is to label a structure, like a loop, with a matching color. How do I do that? With the color picker, of course. I'll put down a while loop. Get rid of this. And let's say I want to label my while loop with a label right inside here, the same color as the while loop. I can easily right-click on the while loop, go to Visible Items, and put down a label, but I can't quite put it where I want it, just inside here. A good option, but not the best for what we want to do. Instead, I'll use a free label. I'd like this free label to be the same color as the loop itself. So I'll come over here to the color picker, or get color. Click on the loop to get that color, and as we see, it's been selected. But it's in the foreground color, and we need it in the background color. So I'll go to my background color and just go to the history. Tab to move back to my position size select tool and nestle it right in here. Arrow up. There we are. A nice option for labeling structures with a solid color. Now go and spread color to your applications.